The elements present in any one group have the same number of valence electrons. For example, fluorine and chlorine belongs to group 17. Groups in the periodic table signify an identical outer shell electronic configuration. The number of shells increases as we go down in the group. There is an anomaly when it comes to the position of hydrogen, because it can be placed either in group 1 or group 17 in the first period. Let's discuss in detail with an example for understanding the position of elements into groups and periods in the periodic table. For example, fluorine. The fluorine atom has 9 valence electrons. Total number of electrons in fluorine atom is 9. Orbit K contains 2 electrons. Orbit L contains 7 electrons, that is, valence electrons. Elements having 7 valence electrons are placed in group 17 of periodic table. The chlorine atom is having 17 valence electrons. As total number of electrons in Cl atom is 17. Orbit K contains 2 electrons. Orbit L contains 8 electrons. Orbit M contains 7 electrons, that is, valence electrons. Elements having 7 valence electrons are placed in group 17 of periodic table. Now let us move on the position of elements in 2 periods in the modern periodic table. Elements do not have the same number of valence electrons, but they contain the same number of shells. The number of valence shell electrons increases by 1 unit, as the atomic number increases by 1 unit on moving from left to right in a period. Atoms of different elements with the same number of occupied shells are placed in the same period. Sodium, magnesium, aluminium, silicon, phosphorus, sulfur, chlorine and argon belong to the third period of the modern periodic table, since the electrons in the atoms of these elements are filled in K, L, and M shells. The maximum number of electrons that can be accommodated in a shell depends on the formula 2n square, where n is the number of the given shell from the nucleus. Let's discuss about the position of elements in 2 periods in detail with an example. Example 1, NK shell N equals 1, as K shell is the first shell from the nucleus. Then 2 multiplied by 1 square equals 2, hence the first period has 2 elements. In L shell N equals 2, as L shell is the second shell from the nucleus. Then 2 multiplied by 2 square 2 equals 8, hence the second period has 8 elements. In M shell N equals 3, M shell is the third shell from the nucleus. Then 2 multiplied by 3 square equals 18, but the outermost shell can have only 8 electrons. So the third period also has only 8 elements. Let us see the general atomic structure of electrons of an atom in energy levels. Here S, P, D, F are subshells to K, L, M, and N shells. The subshell S, which is spherical in shape, has 1 orbital and contains maximum of 2 electrons. The subshell P, which is dumbbell in shape, has 3 orbitals and contains maximum of 6 electrons. The subshell D, which is X-shaped in shape, has 5 orbitals and contains maximum of 10 electrons. The subshell F, which is complex in shape, has 7 orbitals and contains maximum of 14 electrons. Let us discuss how the shells are filled to get valence. Electron arrangement in S, P, D, and F orbitals for lithium, beryllium, boron, carbon, nitrogen, oxygen, fluorine, neon is shown in left side image. As the right image is showing elements with total number of electrons contained by them,